Hi, good evening, everybody. I'm Delphine here. I'm from Singapore and I'm a working mom to three children. So at the same time, I'm also running this digital business on a side hustle basis. So as usual, every week on every Tuesday and Thursday, together with my co-host Angela, who is still in Bangkok now, okay, we are running this digital business podcast talk. Yeah. So Angela?
Yes, hello everyone. My name is Angela Ng. I am also from Singapore. So many of you might already know I'm already living this sort of a digital lifestyle, vacationing for 3 months now in Bangkok. And I will be going back to Singapore pretty soon as well. I'm also a mom. I have two lovely teenagers. And, you know, I'm doing this full time. So I'm a full time digital business owner. And today, the topic that we want to discuss with you about is on social media and how to start social media marketing from scratch. I think everyone must be puzzled, or, you know, if you have zero followers, what, how, you know, when, you know, what will things happen? I don't know about you, Delphine. I mean, in the past, okay, maybe I had Facebook, Instagram, but I wasn't very, very active. I'll post occasionally. My Instagram, maybe sometimes only once a year. You know, my LinkedIn, I had it for a long time, but, you know, I never actually post anything. It was just more on occasionally commenting on other people. Yeah, so as some of you know, maybe you think it's very daunting. Maybe you think you need to have a million followers to, you know, do social media marketing. No, but that's not true. We are able to show you that, you know, as long as you have the will to learn, we have a step-by-step way to teach you how to grow from zero to a thousand to a few thousand. And obviously, you know, the sky's the limit. Yeah. So what about you, Delphine? I mean, were you very active in social media before?
In my personal Facebook, yes, I was, because I used to be, but not now. Okay, because I used to actually treat it as a platform that is a record for my kids' growing milestone. So, and then how we actually, what are the fun things that we have, we do it together, what are the things that happens in our life. So I treat it as a way of recording and as a way of keeping the memories, in Facebook. Yeah, so I did it quite frequently, actually, during when they are younger. But now, you know, there are too many things are occupied. So I only did it once in a while because, you know, I'm enjoying the real life memory creation at the same time. Yeah, but when I started this business, I was told that, you know, we need a social media platform to actually you know, do this digital business. So I was quite worried at the time, because you know, what I usually do, I think as normal people, you know, we usually just post whatever we are happy or wherever we are unhappy of. Whatever we come across, you know, be it a surprise or whatever, we just post it on our personal Facebook, because those are the people that are always following us, which usually our friends, you know, our relatives, yeah, and our colleagues and things like that, people like that. So I was hesitating, actually, how do I actually do that? So when I started this, you know, as usual, we always share about how wonderful this digital business training platform is, the training system, the video-based step-by-step training that has actually prepared for us as a start, as a beginner, to actually start this digital business. So when I started doing that training, I was quite surprised. I was pretty overwhelmed, and it was so awesome. You know, to me, it's like, wow, it's really step-by-step, you know, and it touches on almost all the social media platforms. Like, you know, from YouTube, Facebook, Pinterest, Google Ad, you know. And I think LinkedIn is the next one that I'm not sure whether is it still in there. Yeah,
it is.
So, yeah, it is. It touches almost everything. So I was like, wow.
Seven platforms, and then including TikTok
as
well.
So comprehensive. Then, you know, I was like, oh, okay, so this is where I can get to learn all this thing on how, you know, I should actually put my first step as a beginner to actually run this digital business. So this is something that I felt, well, I'm pretty blessed. I felt that I found this digital business, you know, with such a good training platform that actually teaches us, you know, how to be a social marketer as a beginner. So it really helps 3 years back. Until now, no matter, you know, how seasoned I am as a digital business owner, I still go back to the training platform because it always changes and updates itself, you know, up to what the current social media platform is, you know, in order to be, for us to be on pace with the current trend as well. So this is something that is really very amazing. How about you?
So to be honest, I've been really amazed by the training as well. And lately, because, you know, I also started to do some advertising and, you know, I started to see other people's ad into my feed. One of the things I realized is social media digital marketing is definitely a high in demand skill. Many people want to learn social media digital marketing now. In fact, I responded to one of the ads and inquired. So this company was based in Singapore. How much it would cost, you know, to learn social media marketing if you want the full comprehensive one over a few days. And I would say, you know, even after 2 weeks, I don't think you can master everything. It's more than 10,000. It's more than 10,000 Singapore dollars.
Wow.
It's So each module is maybe a few hundred to a thousand. But because they do it by different module, because can you imagine there are 7 platforms, right? Yeah. It's more than $10,000, which is why when I actually relate to this business, you know, whatever that we are asking people to invest here, it's really nothing. So that's why I always think back, to be honest, you know, this business, there is really no risk because what we're learning here is really golden, you know, skills that's going to equip us for our next future. For those of you, maybe you never thought that you want to be in social media, but think about it. Everyone is using social media. Even our politicians are using social media, right? I always see, for example, you know, Lawrence Wong, our, you know, next to be prime minister. I always see his Instagram feeds, you know? So even politicians have to do it. So it really strikes me, maybe it doesn't strike other people yet, but it's such an important skill to have, your own personal branding, because gone on the days people are going to, you know, advertise on newspapers or magazines anymore. And social media is the fastest way. And in a way, it's kind of like your social proof as well. Yeah.
Correct. Actually, nowadays, when you talk about newspaper, I was thinking, nowadays, I seldom see people actually distributing pamphlets. You know, there are days whereby, there's a lot of people that are, you know, on the road distributing pamphlets, you know, trying to advertise for their business, But I think nowadays, I saw more on people advertising actually on social media because this is actually a more, you know, a daily platform that everybody is actually, you know, looking through every day, so you won't get to miss it. Actually, you won't even, you know, get to miss a day where you're actually scrolling through your social media platforms as well at the same time. You know, that's why.
And also, you know, for some of you who are maybe afraid about social media, thinking that maybe I'm not pretty enough, I can't dance, I don't want to do silly videos. We don't have to do all that sort of things in our business. You have never asked me to come and, you know, do dancing. But if you one day you see me dancing, it's because I'm happy and I'm, you know, genuinely just doing some sort of dancing activity, but not for the sake of posting. So it's something which people should think about if they want to present themselves as a grandmother, just happily cooking every day, they can. Somebody who wants to present themselves as a mom, looking after their children, cooking for them, you know, showing love to their children, running chores, picking their children up, doing activities, Or if you want to be shown as somebody like me who loves to travel, showing, where I travel, what I like to eat, for example, that's also all doable. In fact, most of you are already doing that on your Facebook page, right? So it's all about, sharing on who you are. So this actually nothing really special. But when you actually join this business, you are going to gain so much skill and insight to social media platforms and discover how algorithm works, how you get followers, how you get increased engagement, and how you entertain other people. So for me, it's really valuable.
Yes, I think a lot of people actually is afraid that what sort of content do I need to post? I don't have ideas. I'm not creative. I'm not innovative. Actually, all these are, you'll be surprised, all these are taught in the training. On top of the training, we have our weekly mastermind as well, where they share about how we can actually run our digital business, on our platform more efficiently, more fun, having fun, while being, while not thinking of it as being stressed out, So initially when I run this business, I felt a little bit stressed out because I wasn't that capable of what type of thing do I have to post? What type of content? Am I doing this good? Is this correct? And things like that. So I tend to think a lot of all these things. But as I go along, going through the trainings, attending the mastermind, hearing out all the replay mastermind, sharing and things like that, it's always come to a point where you have to run, you when you run this digital business, you have to enjoy the process. Okay? Because when you have the enjoyment in running the process of running this digital business, you will naturally, you will have the ability to actually post the correct content to attract the audience that you want. So how do you create content? All these are taught in the training. Okay, how to understand what our audience is actually suitable or the right audience that you want is also taught in this training as well as the mastermind. So a lot of things that I tends to overthink in the past when I started this digital business is actually all covered in the trainings as well as in the mastermind that we actually have it on a weekly basis. So you don't have to worry about, you are just like what Angela has shared, if you're a grandma, you can just show your cooking skill, what do you prepare for your loved ones, every day or every meal, So this digital business actually is suitable for everybody, okay? Regardless of how old you are, of course there is an age whereby you can only start this digital business because this is a taxable income business. So you have to start, I think it's 18 years old, but
18, minimum 18 years old.
there's no ending age. So we have grandma who are actually running this digital business and she's running so successfully in this digital business. So I have someone who actually asked me, a few days ago, he's a grandfather. So he's saying that, I do not know much about digital business. I do not know much about social media platform. So how can I do it? Can I, am I capable of doing it? So I would like to also address this at the same time, because we are not trained actually to be a digital marketer as well. Okay. I'm good at my own job. I'm good at my day job. I'm good at being a mom. Okay. But not in digital marketing. I know nuts about it. But after you embark on this digital business, you have the trainings, you have everything prepared for you. You have a mentor guidance, so you will be a very good, as a beginner, you have all these things that is actually laid out for you to actually for you to go through the trainings and learn from all these people, learn from the training platform as well, in order to actually train you to be a very good social media digital marketer at the same time. So don't have fear on that. I used to have fear on that. So don't have fear on that. Give a try on this digital business where you will see more how it actually can change your lifestyle at the same time as well.
Yeah, I mean, something for me to add is yes, maybe I have quite a lot of experience in marketing, but I didn't have any experience in social media digital marketing. Even if I did, the platform, it's always evolving. So people will have to relearn their skills, update their skills all the time. So I hope for any of you who are interested to, level up your skill, learn a new skill. Think about how valuable our business model can be for you. It's not just about starting your own business, earning from a side hustle, but it's also upgrading yourself, getting a new skill. So I hope you check us out. We have a complimentary webinar. You can watch, you know, our links are at the bottom, or Delphine's. And I hope to chat with some of you soon. Okay.
Yep.
So we'll be here again on Thursday to answer any of your questions. And yeah, see you soon, Delphine.
Have a good evening too. Enjoy your trip. We'll see you back in Singapore.
Okay.
See you, everybody.
Bye. Bye.